Hello, my friend. Welcome to TubeU channel. Today, I will provide you with detailed information on how to utilize Stable Diffusion's ComfyUI. Let's get started. First, you may notice absence of extension submenu like automatic 1111 at the beginning. To resolve this, we will install the essential extension code ComfyUI Manager. Visit the homepage mentioned in the description below and copy the git clone command. Next, navigate to the ComfyUI folder, specifically the custom nodes subfolder. Open the command prompt by typing cmd and paste the command copied from the homepage. This will install the extension. Afterward, restart ComfyUI and the interface. Now, you will see a manager at the bottom. Click this button to access the extension manager, where you will find various available extensions. Search for WAS, and you will come across this extension. It includes a multitude of new node suites and enhances the functionality of the original ComfyUI nodes. Check the box and click the Install button. The third extension to consider is ControlNet preprocessors. Search for ControlNet and install this extension. Even though the official ControlNet currently only has Canny and Depths released, these preprocessors are already prepared. However, I have encountered some preprocessors that don't work as expected. I will leave them here in hopes they will be fixed in the future. It is worth noting that these preprocessors are quite large, totally about 10 GB. After restarting ComfyUI, it may take a little while to install them all. With these three basic and essential extensions installed, you are ready to go. Open a new ComfyUI and load the default interface. Each window in the interface is treated as a node. While windows may have different appearance, they generally display their properties and functionalities, which can be modified if necessary. Some windows have input and output ports based on their functions, along with content parameters and output graphs or content. For example, let's examine the load checkpoint window. You can load the checkpoint file from the CKPT name field, such as SDXL base motor. This load checkpoint window has only output ports. Input and output ports can be connected if they are paired, or you can use text bridge to connect them if necessary. To do this, for instance, you can't directly connect the load checkpoint output clip to the positive or negative of KS samplers. You will need to add some text to explain the information that the KS samplers can understand. To achieve this, double-click and search for text, and find clip text encode. Now, you can link them through this text bridge, ensuring these have the same color. Keep in mind that the content and input ports of windows can change. For example, in the K-sampler window, right-click to open the shortcut menu and select Convert Seed to Input. You will then need to input the seed separately. You can revert this by selecting Convert Seed Input to Widget. It is crucial to ensure that every window's input and output are correctly filled out. Otherwise, the queue will stop at the point and display in red. If a window hasn't changed, the queue will not process unless you modify something. Lastly, here are several useful shortcuts you can employ in ComfyUI. Left-click and drag to move the entire workflow. Right-click to add a new node. Double-click to access the search option. Middle scroll on the mouse to zoom in or out of the workflow. Right-click above a node for shortcut options, which vary based on the main target. Ctrl-C copies the content. Ctrl-V pastes the content. And Ctrl plus Shift plus V pastes the content with the link. You can make area selection with Ctrl-dragging the mouse. And by holding Shift while moving the mouse, you can move the selection together. To mute a node, not run it, press Ctrl-M, and pressing Ctrl-M again will unmute the node. Creating groups in ComfyUI is similar to other Windows applications. When you move the group area to cover nodes, these nodes will move along with the group area. You can move the entire group by left-clicking on the tab. If you only want to move the group area itself, press Ctrl and Tab. And then you can move only the group area to any location. Now let's start creating our workflow using the SDXL modal. First, clear the workflow. Then, load the SDXL modal using the load checkpoint function. This modal requires text prompt input. The encoded text will be used by KSampler in the core part. After Stable Diffusion calculates using a sampler algorithm, the information will be decoded and sent to the output to generate the final image. This process is similar to how it works in Stable Diffusion. Next, edit the refiner modal. You can copy the entire workflow as a starting point, and then delete the latent image. Since we will use the same resolution, the latent output will be used as the refiner input. This setup works well. However, the output image may differ from the input image due to a large denoising value. Let's decrease it to around 0.2 to keep the original image almost the same, while adding more detailed information to the final image. Now, let's scale the image and add image to image scaling node. You can adjust the scaling factor directly. For increased speed, fix the seed. You can choose different scaling methods and automatically save the image using the Save Image Output node. Consider using date-named folders for saving images, as mentioned in my previous video. You can also use built-in scaling methods like 4x upscaling to make the output image clear and larger. As you add more nodes, the workflow becomes more complex. You can use Add Reroute to create a template connection to keep it clear and organized. For instance, KSampler has four inputs, so create a four-line template connection for it. If you want to use the same positive and negative prompt for the base and the refiner modal, change the text to input. Then use collapse to minimize the node windows, making the whole workflow cleaner. Now, let's incorporate ControlNet into the workflow. If you are using the same checkpoint as the main flow, then you can employ the same template link here. Otherwise, you will need to add a new load checkpoint node. The same applies to the ControlNet starting image. If you are using the new image, then here you should add a load new image node, or simply use the main output image as the starting image. In this scenario, we are using a new checkpoint and the old image as the starting point. We will add other necessary nodes to generate the image output. It is important to note that the ControlNet preprocessors and the ControlNet modal should be of the same version. After changing the hair and the shirt colors, we can observe that the output image matches our expectations. The ControlNet workflow is functioning seamlessly. Don't forget that copy and paste can be used across different windows. I have created a ControlNet template that includes all processors. You can easily copy any of them to your workflow. While there are only two official ControlNet options available, you can use the Canny ControlNet to process the headline preprocessors treat the image as input. It can still generate an image, although the output image may not be as expected. You can easily align multiple ControlNet processes if necessary. Another useful tip is that on the ComfyUI or ControlNet homepage, if a figure is in PNG format, it might include the entire workflow. You can download and load the image to try it out, then integrate it into your workflow. All of these techniques will speed up your learning curve and help you build your own workflow efficiently. If you're enjoying my content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching.